Thank you for taking my case. I don't have anyone else to turn to. Please, call me Renee. You see, my dear Alfred was quite ill. I'm sure you understand the nature of it. But we found a doctor who could cure Alfred's condition. Professor Jerome Swens keeps a sanatorium in the Alps for those with paranormal disturbances. So I said goodbye to Alfred. He left for the sanatorium. That was the last time I saw him. The next time I heard from Alfred, he sent his pocket watch with a letter telling me our marriage was over. It didn't even sound like my Alfred. You've got to find him for me.
waiting for you. Your reputation precedes you. You're the one who's ruined so many of the Brotherhood's fine plans. First, at Mystic Hospital, and then at Cinderstone. We almost beat you at the theater. Renee, please continue.
Sorry.
We need you working for us, not against us. This won't hurt a bit. It's all for the best, really. You'll see.
Apologies for treating you so heinously. Dr. Swens left me a little choice. He's been carrying out experiments here. But there wasn't anything I could do to stop him. When I heard of his plan to brainwash you, I had to act. The professor's mind suppressors are distributed throughout the sanatorium. Here, this bracelet will make you immune to their effects, but don't get too close to them or you'll see. I left something on your table. I must go, or I'll be discovered. Please, you've got to stop that man.
patient, Mr. R. Brad's newspaper magnate. Idea to implant. Everything his newspapers have published is a lie. The only way to save your journalistic integrity is to join the Brotherhood and publish our truths. Notes. The brain device worked, but we are still awaiting full results. We'll continue to monitor and repeat the procedure in 1 week if needed.
Probably another one of my libel victims. I don't deserve your company. I once won a Pulitzer. Journalism was everything to me. The great fourth estate. Then I met Dr. Swens. He made me see the light. Everything ever written in my papers was a lie. There, go on, see for yourself. Lies. All lies.
Thank you.
Oh, my head. What a doozy. Hey, I'm alive. That professor is certainly no friend of mine. He tried to make me his paper boy. I overheard Renee and Dr. Swens talking.
Dr. Swens, our patient has completely lost his mind. We've got to stop this.
Nonsense. My invention is perfection. Soon, the most influential people in the world will be under my control. The Brotherhood will prevail. Get out of my way. Don't forget who's in charge here, or I'll make you one of my patients.
Renee tried to stop him, but he got rough with her. I'll show that guy a thing or two. And the kid. Oh, that's a sad one. Uh-oh. I'm not feeling so hot.
patient Mary Moreau, an actress. Idea to implant, she'll be irrelevant as she ages. The only way for you to remain a star is to join the Brotherhood. Notes: the device worked. Side effects: apathy. Mary sits in the garden, exhibiting no emotion. We'll try our therapy again in 2 weeks.
I want to be alone. My star has faded. I once played Juliet on Broadway. Now I'm over the hill, and no one will cast me. That's it for my career. I'll never get a good role again. It's all extras for me. Please, go away.
Thank you. Thank you.
What a fool I've been! How could I let Dr. Swens do that to me? I'm better than this. Thanks for snapping me out of it. Say, why don't I help you by staying undercover? The prof won't know any difference. I remember that lug's next move.
I only want VIPs. Those who can influence others with their positions. Lydia, Black, prepare the room for our child prodigy.
Maybe that tidbit will help you. Ugh, I can barely stomach all that's happened.
patient Emil Ekberg, a child prodigy, son of a renowned physicist. Idea to implant. Emil's father neglects him and doesn't love him. The Brotherhood is your family now. You will invent things for us, and we'll always care for you. Notes. This time, the brain device failed. Emil became paranoid and ran away. We'll locate him and try again.
Leave me alone. I don't need you. I don't need anyone. My mother died, and my father chose his precious science over me. So I learned not to need anyone. They will protect me. I think I should apologize to you. I was so scared. Scared and angry. That was me. I thought I never wanted to see my father again. But the truth is, I miss him. You've got to stop Dr. Swens. He's crazy. One time, I followed him to the forest. Oh, it was awful. I'll stay here, so he doesn't suspect I've been cured.
patient, Oliver Bird, a respected pharmacist. Idea to implant. He was distracted by his quest for a cure and neglected his own sick family, who died because of him. The Brotherhood will reunite you with your family. Notes. We had to chain Oliver to a tree. We presented him with two options: join us or be consumed by guilt. My life is worthless. My ambition got the best of me. And my family paid the price. Their deaths are on my head. I deserve this. Please, let me suffer.
Thank you.
Now I see that their deaths were inevitable. But still, I wish I had been there for them. Thank you for clearing the fog from my brain. I wish there was something I could do to help. Wait, maybe there is. Dr. Swens took me to a cave. I was supposed to mix drugs there for him, but I refused. There were papers there, important documents. They could give you some answers. I better stay hidden for now. Good luck to you.
Agent Adamic. I don't know how you got as far as you did. It's either luck or your paranormal skill. And if it's your mind-tapping ability, that's what I want. Dr. Swens always gets what he wants. So long, Agent Adamic. Don't lose your head over this.
Enough! You've ruined the greatest invention in the history of mankind. I should have killed you on first sight. I believe this is still mine. You'll pay for everything you've done.
No!
That was rather convenient. I'll take over from here, and the Brotherhood will think you killed Swens. It's a pity to waste a good agent this way, but you leave me no choice.
Bye. Boo!
That was a stunning defeat. Renee can never hurt us again.